Sand.
Sand?
Yes.
Very good. And if you look around, go ahead and land on the sand and tell me once you've gotten there. Are you there?
Yes.
Awesome. And I want you to look at the sand. What color is it?
It's multicolor.
Ah, multicolor sand. Very nice. And is the sand on the shoreline?
No.
So are you in a desert-like area, or is there water there?
It's a desert-like area.
Ah, very good. And how far out ahead of you does the sand go?
Oh, for miles. Goes to the tree line.
Oh, very good. And what does the tree line look like?
To have big leaves, like palm trees almost.
Oh, very nice. Anything you've ever seen before?
No.
Oh, very good. And look down where you're standing now again. What do your feet look like?
This feels like I'm floating.
It feels like you're floating?
Yes.
Oh, very nice. And I want you to feel your body at all with whatever you have to feel it with. How do you feel?
Feel light.
Oh, very good. Are you young or are you old?
Young.
Oh, very good. And do you have hands at all?
Yes.
Hold them out in front of you. What do they look like?
They look like three fingers.
Ah, you have three fingers?
Yes.
Very good. And what color is your skin?
It's like a teal purple color.
A teal purple. Very nice, sir. And I want you to feel yourself. Feel your face and your head and see how does that feel. How does your head feel?
Feels a little bumpy.
Ah, a little bumpy.
Yes.
So put your hands where your ears would be, and what's there?
They're open.
Just like a
hole in the side.
Ah, very good. Now go ahead and run your hands to the top where your hair would normally be, and what's up there?
Feels like spikes.
How sharp are the spikes, or are they almost like turtle skin spikes?
Almost like turtle skin.
Ah, very good. And what is the texture of the skin?
It's a little scaly.
Ah, it's very scaly. Okay, and I want you to put your hands where your eyes are and feel your eyes and tell me what they, you know, the shape of them. What does that feel like?
They feel almost like an oval.
Very good. And run your hand over your nose area or your mouth. And what does that feel like?
Nose, I don't have one.
Very good.
My mouth and teeth are a little sharp.
Okay. Is your mouth round? Feels round?
Yes.
Oh, very good. I've actually met I believe the species before. Someone else said the same. He was levitating as well. When you look down at where your body, like feel your body, and how far does it go? Are there any type of feet or appendages? Are they just hanging or what's there? If you can feel with your hand on at the bottom of your body, please.
I feel like it's just hanging.
Ah, very good. So can you kick them or move them around?
Yeah, a little bit.
Ah, very good. So basically you don't have to walk at all then, huh?
No.
Awesome. So I want you to slowly turn around. I guess you're on another planet. When you look up in the sky, what does the sky look like above you? Is it what time of day or is it?
It's like it's almost night. You can see daylight in the horizon though.
Ah, so does it look like it's in the sun is getting ready to rise?
Yes.
Oh, very good. And so straight out ahead of you across the sand, you can see a tree line. Is that far away or close?
It's pretty far.
Okay. Now I want you to slowly turn around and tell me what's behind you in the other direction.
The direction is nothing.
Ah, okay. Very good. Let's Let's move across. This is like a sand dune, but as you say, it's a multicolored sand dune,
yes.
Or like a huge field with just is it beautiful?
Very beautiful.
Ah, very good. And if you look through the sand, do you see any type of plants or any type of animals or insects or anything type of movement where it looks like anything something's alive in it within it?
No.
Ah, very good. So let's get over to the tree line, and we're going to get there really fast. We're going to get there in a count of 5, 4, 3, halfway there, 2, almost there, and 1, you're there. Now that you're close up to the tree line, how big are the plants that you saw?
Huge. The biggest plants I've ever seen.
Oh my goodness, and how big are you compared to them?
Not that big. I'm only about big as one of the leaves.
Oh, really interesting. And I wonder how actually tall you are compared. Do you think there's a probability that... Oh, hold it. Do you have wings?
Yes.
Ah. You have wings. So that's how you're up in the air. Did you know you had wings the whole time?
No.
Not until you just realize, hey, this is how I'm flying. I want you to, what do the wings feel like? Just by, without having to look, what do they feel like? How do you think they're shaped?
Oh no, it's... They're shaped pretty funny, it feels like.
That's just what you're moving them on your back, right?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Now I want you to go ahead and look over your shoulder and see if you can, and tell me what they look like as you look back and not at them. And how far can your head turn back?
They're pretty big.
The wings are pretty big?
Yes, they are.
How did it compare to your body? How many times do you think they're bigger?
2 times my body.
Wow, and what is the wings made of?
Almost like a membrane.
So like a wasp or a bee or something, huh?
Yes.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. See, that other person that went under, he was that as well. I can't wait to see. Very good. We're going to leave that scene there for a moment, and we're going to go to where you live. We're going to go to where you live, and I'm probably in that forest there, and we're going to be there in a count of 5, 4, 3, halfway there, 2, almost there, and 1. You're there. Where are you now?
Like a cave in the middle of the middle of everything.
A cave in the middle of everything. What does that mean?
I guess maybe it's where I live. Feels comfortable.
Are you inside the cave?
Yes.
Oh, very nice. And just look around the cave. How is it lit up? Is it lit up at all?
Yes.
And how is it lit?
It's a natural glow.
There's a natural glow to the ceiling, the walls.
The walls.
Really excellent. And how are the walls shaped?
Circular, almost.
The circular walls. And does it look like a natural construct or like you hollow that place out? Or?
It looks hollowed out.
Oh, very good. And it's the opening to get in and out. Is it? I want you to face the opening on how you enter and exit and compare the opening to the size of your wings. How easy is it to get in and out?
It's pretty easy. And wings fold back.
Ah, very good. And is there a small tunnel before you get into the interior, or you go through the wall and you're directly inside the hollowed-out space?
It's a small tunnel.
Ah, very good.
Just big enough to fly through.
Ah, very good. And then land as you get through it, huh?
Yes.
Very nicely. And as you look around, is there any type of technology or any type of furniture or anything like that that seems like it's been constructed?
No.
Very good. Very primitive then, would you would say?
Yes.
Ah, and is there anyone else within the structure?
No.
And can you see entrances to other parts of the, or is it just that one initial space there?
No, it's a few more.
And I want you to really listen and feel Do you think you're the only one inside there?
No.
Oh, very good. Well, one of the ones that are in there, they're going to come out. And I want you to tell me who it is when they come out and what they look like. Don't be surprised. I think they're coming out. Who is this? Has anyone stepped out yet?
No.
No? You feel them in the space, huh?
Yeah.
Well, I want you to go ahead and move to where you feel they're at. And what does it look like as you're going deeper in?
It's getting bigger.
It's getting bigger?
Yes.
And are you going through a tunnel?
Yeah.
Okay, so you were just in the beginning part when you landed in, right?
Yes.
Very good. And tell me what it looks like as you walk into this larger area, or fly into this larger area.
The top of the cave has shining.
Shining?
Yeah, the stalagmites, the stalactites.
Oh, stalactites hanging down?
Yes.
And you say they're shining?
Yes.
Oh, beautiful. Are they like crystals?
Yeah.
Wow, do they put out a lot of light?
Yes, they do.
Wow. And it lights up the cavern. How big is the cavern?
It's big enough for a small city.
Oh, wow. Awesome. And are there others, inside flying around?
Yes.
Does it almost look like a huge beehive or something?
Yes.
Very good. And go ahead, in your own words, just describe as much as you can see. Anything that stands out, if they're working or they're doing things, if they're transporting things, whatever you see that's going on.
Yes, everyone's flying back and forth, carrying something.
No one's running into each other at all, are they?
No.
And I want you to watch someone that's carrying something, and they're just going to freeze right there in mid-flight. No one else will even notice. I want you to fly up close and tell me exactly what it is they're carrying.
A little small block.
A little small block. And what is the block? What color is it? Or what does it look like it is?
It's like a golden orange with yellow and red going through it.
So do you think they're possible food or larvae or babies?
It's food.
Ah, it's food. Food that's been what, manufactured or made by you guys in there?
Yes.
Ah, very good. And where are they getting it from, and where does it seem like they're taking them?
They're taking them all home.
Oh, to their individual
yes.
sessions that go into the hive, right?
Yes.
So, because it sounds like a hive.
Yes.
It's interesting to really see how big you are, because there's no comparison. Do you think you're a big size, or do you think that there's a probability you may be insect size? Especially
big size.
Oh, you're a big size. Okay. Very good. So, I want you to, entity, are they still frozen there?
Yes.
Oh, very good. You're going to go ask some questions, and they're going to answer whatever you have. They'll do whatever it takes to please you. So they'll answer all your questions, and they won't feel strange that you're asking. I don't know how you communicate. But I want you either telepathically think of what is the name of the place to them, and see what you get back. Or is there a name?
There's no name.
Well, ask them to tell you any and everything you can about this place.
Well, he says for as long as he can remember, we've been here. So the elders say it's been over 5 millennia.
Ah, Very good. And where are you located? Are you on the planet Earth?
No.
You're not on the planet Earth. Very good. Are you in the solar system of the Earth?
No, we're like a couple of light years away.
Ah, very good. Very, very good. And you obviously are from that place. So very good. Let's let him go ahead and go. And he unfreezes and he just keeps flying as if he's never even talked to you. And are you still looking around at everything?
Yes.
I want you to move to where there's someone who can give you all the information about that place. It's somewhere where they can give you all the information. And we're going to be there. Maybe it's a council member. In the count of 5, 4, or some of the elders, 3, halfway there, 2, almost there, and 1. Where are you now?
Standing in front of one of the elders.
Ah, very good. Well, just let the elder know that you're bi-locating from the Earth, and you have a few questions about where you are and how you come to be. And do they mind answering any questions?
No, they don't mind at all.
Oh, very good. Well, tell them that you're on the Earth and you're, well, they probably already know, but just in case, you're on the Earth and you're bi-locating here, and is this your place of origin?
Yes, it's my place of origin.
And ask them, do they know how long you've been stationed on the planet Earth, or how long you've been on the Earth, and, you know, how many times have you been to the Earth?
It's my second time.
Ah, very good. And what motivated you to come to the Earth?
First, it was just the vacation, see something different.
And when you came in that vacation time, did you physically manifest as a human, or how did you manifest?
It wasn't a human.
So, and when you first came, in terms of your linear expression, now it's 2015, in that linear perspective, how long ago was it that you came the first time? How many millennia is here on the planet Earth? How far back? Oh, very good. So, a long time ago. And what has motivated you to come the second time around, then?
I wanted to see how much everything had changed.
Oh, very good. And are you lending your energy to the planet because of it's going through a huge transformation?
Yes.
And is that any part of the decision-making process for you to come to the Earth at this time?
Yes.
Is that what they're saying?
Yes.
Very good. And the council actually has a message for you, which is why you're standing there in front of them. Ask them what is their message to you. Loud and clear, you may repeat it.
You're telling me I'm doing a great job.
Awesome.
And in a while, it'll be time for me to come back.
Oh, very good. And how?
They said I will know when I see a signal.
Oh, very good. And ask them, will they ever physically manifest on the Earth, futuristically, when the vibration is right? in their current form.
So there's no...
no precedent. What's the name of your race? Do you have it? Is there a name of that, that species or race?
Yes.
Could you say it out loud?
Thorax.
Thorax. Very good. And ask them how many thorax have physically manifested on the planet at this time.
This is about 30.
Ah, just 30, not many.
Yes, not many.
Very good. I had a friend named Tony DeLeon. Is he a part of their race as well?
Yes, he is.
He described himself just very good. Very, very good. And just 28 more then, huh?
Yes.
Is there anyone that we know or that Hank knows that could possibly be a part of the Thorax race as well? That they could share? Any relatives in your family?
No.
Very good. Just interesting. We're just curious, really curious. So, where you come, Thorax, and the area that you're from, that is where Mike came from initially. After, he came from there and then came to the planet Earth, is that correct?
Yes.
And how many aspects of Mike is manifested here on the planet? Is there more than just one him here playing out this frequency of bandwidth?
No.
Oh, very good. Does he have any connection off this planet with any of his family members or with Hank? His Uncle Hank, Henry?
Yes.
And where is he known as Uncle Henry from before this physical incarnation?
Another distant planet.
Another distant planet. Do they have any information about that distant planet at all?
Very little.
Oh, very good. And is he a good, is the memory a good memory?
Yes.
Oh, very good. And what was the relationship in that memory or in that interaction?
We were good friends.
Oh, very good. Very, very good. What do they foresee happening after the vibrational shift here on the planet Earth, when it finally shifts into, say, fifth dimension or conscious fifth dimension within the inhabitants of the planet, human and everything else?
Say
loud and clear. What did they say?
They say.
Long, slow, deep breath through your nose. Inhale. Allow the information to flow. Let it out slow. Hiss it out. And two more long, slow, deep breaths. And feel yourself relaxing. Your vibration is raising. You can hear them. And let it go slowly. Control it. You're getting deeper and deeper. Last one. Long, slow, deep breath. Let it out. You can hear everything they're saying. You can see the impressions. You understand what they show you. And what are they saying about that?
They say eventually the Earth will be ready.
In your lifetime?
Yes.
Very good. And after the earth makes the shift, is that when you have a choice to stay or go?
Yes.
And what do they foresee you doing, staying or going? It'll be your choice.
Yeah, it will be my choice. I told them I want to stay.
Awesome, awesome. So what do you foresee? What do they foresee here on the earth in your future? Do they see you with a mate and some offspring?
Yes.
Very good. Very good. If you look around, you might be able to see them there even before they've, or have they made that choice yet? Are they waiting in the future for you?
Yes.
Can you see them?
Vaguely.
A little spark of light?
Yes.
Oh, very good. Very, very good. Can you feel their energy? If you can tell if they are deciding to be a male or a female when they get to you?
Yes.
Go ahead and feel it out. What do you think the first one will be? What do you feel from those vague lights that you see?
Female.
Your first would be a female. Are you even interested to know what the other one would possibly be? Is there more than one? Do you see two? How many do you see?
See two.
You feel two and see two. Very good. Just a little faint light, huh? So you know what that means. They're over there waiting for you to get it together. So when they're the ones going to come through, ask them, how does this help you, the session that you're doing? What's the reason why you're able to see what you can see and get what you can get from the console? What does the console say?
It's been a long time since they've seen me.
Very good. So ask them, how many lives have you been on the planet? Has it been longer than just the two that you think, or has there been more?
They say it's been a couple more.
Very good. And that's here, were you human or were you something else?
Or something else.
Very good. That's interesting to know, because that's a lot of time to take up with since you've been away for so long. What else were you when you came through? The council knows.
Yeah.
How many council members are there? One or two now? Or, yeah.
A whole council is there.
Very
They're
good.
They're just speaking to one.
Understood. Very good. Is there a hive mind with this?
Yes.
All right. Very good. Very, very good. And amazing, amazing, amazing. And what? Now, where describe the area that you're in and what it looks like where the council is, or how the one is. What do you see in that space, please?
It's a big opening, and each individual council member has a section that they sit in. The one who's speaking is like on the, like in the middle.
Oh, very good. And are you on a stage or a panel before them?
Yes.
Do you feel like that if you, there's probably nothing you could answer? And ask them, how long have you been a part of that species?
I could ask anything.
Awesome. And they have the answers then?
To the best of their knowledge.
Very good. Well, we're just interested in your entity, your energy, who you are, who Mike Jones is. And we know he's been on this planet as a few other things. And we're just out of curiosity. Could they tell you what a few of those are?
They're open.
Yeah,
just like a hole in the side.
Oh, very good. Now go ahead and run your hands to the top, where your hair would normally be, and what's up there?
Feels like spikes.
How sharp are the spikes, or are they almost like turtle skin spikes?
Almost like turtle skin.
Very good. And what is the texture of the skin?
little scarily.
Ah, it's very scarily. Okay, and I want you to put your hands where your eyes are and feel your eyes and tell me what they, you know, the shape of them. What does that feel like?
I feel almost like an oval.
Very good. And run your hand over your nose area or your mouth. And what does that feel like?
Nose, I don't have one.
Very good.
My mouth and teeth are a little sharp.
Okay. Is your mouth round? Feels round?
Yes.
Oh, very good. I've actually met, I believe, the species before. Someone else said the same. He was levitating as well. When you look down at where your body, like feel your body, and how far does it go? Are there any type of feet or appendages? Are they just hanging or what's there? If you can feel with your hand on at the bottom of your body, please.
I feel like it's just hanging.
Ah, oh, very good. So, can you kick them or move them around?
Yeah, a little bit.
Ah, oh, very good. So basically, you don't have to walk at all then, huh?
No.
Awesome. So I want you to slowly turn around. I guess you're on another planet. When you look up in the sky, what does the sky look like above you? Is it what time of day or is it?
It's like it's almost night. You can see daylight in the horizon, though.
Oh, so does it look... It feels like you're floating?
Yes.
Ah, oh, very nice. And I want you to feel your body at all with whatever you have to feel it with. How do you feel?
Feel light.
Oh, very good. Are you young or are you old?
Young.
Oh, very good. And so you can you say, okay, now I want you to, do you have hands at all?
Yes.
Hold them out in front of you. What do they look like?
They look like a three fingers.
Ah, you have three fingers.
Yes.
Very good. And what color is your skin?
It's like a teal purple color.
A teal purple. Very nice, sir. And I want you to feel yourself. Feel your face and your head and see how does that feel. How does your head feel?
Feels a little bumpy.
Ah, a little bumpy.
Yes.
So put your hands where your ears would be, and what's there?
Sand.
Sand?
Yes.
Very good. And if you look around, go ahead and land on the sand and tell me what you've gotten there. Are you there?
Yes.
Awesome. And I want you to look at the sand. What color is it?
It's multicolor.
Ah, multicolor sand. Very nice. And, is the sand on the shoreline?
No.
So are you in a desert-like area, or is there water there?
It's a desert-like area.
Oh, very good. And how far out ahead of you does the sand go?
Oh, miles. Goes to the tree line.
Oh, very good. And what does the tree line look like?
To have big leaves. Like palm trees, almost.
Ah, oh, very nice. Anything you've ever seen before?
No.
Ah, oh, very good. And look down where you're standing now again. What do your feet look like?
This feels like I'm floating.
Like it's in, the sun is getting ready to rise?
Yes.
Ah, oh, very good. And so, straight out ahead of you, across the sand, you can see a tree line. Is that far away or close?
It's pretty far.
Okay. Now I want you to slowly turn around and tell me what's behind you in the other direction.
The direction is nothing.
Ah, okay. Very good. Let's move across. This is like a sand dune, but as you say, it's a multicolored sand dune?
Yes.
Or like a huge field with just, is it beautiful?
Very beautiful.
Ah, very good. And if you look through the sand, do you see any type of plants or any type of animals or insects or anything type of movement where it looks like anything, something's alive in it, within it?
No.
Ah, very good. So let's get over to the tree line, and we're going to get there really fast. We're going to get there in the count of 5, 4,